Guys, it's your boy, DCI Gaming, and as you guys know, FIFA 17 is coming out in 2 months. Today is July the 1st. So, FIFA 17 is coming out in what? September the 29th? And you guys want to get off to a good start. You guys want to have that full legend team by the end of FIFA 17. You want to be beating all your friends. You want to be the best of the best. But you don't know how to. Well, I'm going to be teaching you 5 easy steps on how to get a good start on FIFA 17 and get ahead right at the word go. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe and smash that like button. If we hit 10 likes, I will do another video like this. So, yeah. Our first step into getting a good start in FIFA 17 is using the web app. Now, the web app comes out 2 days before we can play on FIFA 17, so this is key to opening packs and making a good team. It is a very key part in making FIFA 17 a better game for you and getting a good start, because while everyone is waiting for the game to come out, you can make a good start using the web app. Number 2 on the list of tips is opening packs. Now, at the start of FIFA, on all FIFAs, the players' prices are up a lot. They're worth a lot more, so it's more likely to get good players in packs. So an 83 rated player will be worth 20k. So opening packs is really important, so you can pull really good players, and with the coins you get, make a really good team. This is key to getting a good start to FIFA 17. My third tip for everyone is playing tournaments. Now, playing tournaments has special rewards like packs, coins, and a lot of different stuff. This can make the difference to getting a good start and a bad start. If you get a pack, you might be able to get a good pull, and it can make a really big difference. And if you earn coins, that can go a long way to making your team better. So that's why playing tournaments earns you coins and gets you packs. It's very important. At number 4, we have looking for cheap players. Now, when you start off, you don't want to make a boss team. You don't want to have Zlatan, Messi, and Ronaldo. You just want to get the cheap players because the prices of everyone is up. So you don't want to buy them. You got to wait for their prices to go down, then buy them. So look for the cheap players that are around 500 to 1k each and make a team with that. And once the prices go down, then make a better team with the coins you've earned with that team. It will go a long way because you would have earned a lot of coins by the time the prices have gone down. So it's a good thing to do. Guys, my 5th and final tip for you guys is find a good trading method. Now, if you find a good trading method and just find a way to keep earning coins and keep getting your budget up in between games, this is probably the biggest way to earn your coins. If you can find a way to earn 1k per player, it can make a huge difference. You can go a long way. You can make a great team, 1k per player. Just keep doing that in between all your games and you've got it in the bag. You're gonna make a really good team. You're gonna have 50k and it's gonna make a huge difference. It is gonna make your team so good. That is my biggest tip, and this is a must do if you want to get a good start on FIFA 17. So guys, that's all my tips for you. Please subscribe and smash that like button. If we can hit 10 likes, I will do another video on FIFA 17 tips, and I'll do another 5 tips. So hit 10 likes and I will do that. And that's all I can say, guys. Peace out.